Hi, this can only be Rides with Chuck. In this video, we talk with the owner of a 1931 American LaFrance fire engine. Then, we go for a ride. We shot this video a couple of weeks after the September 11th terrorist attacks. Those were pretty dark days.
What exactly was the role of this fire engine during a fire?
It's a 1,000 gallon a minute pumper. It'll provide 1,000 gallons a minute to a fire scene, and it would be either hooked up to a hydrant or set up to draft from a pond or a cistern or a river to supply water.
When was the last time this fire engine was actually used in fire prevention?
I believe it was sold by Spring Valley. Spring Valley kept it as a backup until the mid to late 70s when it was sold to a private individual in DeKalb.
When did you acquire this fire engine?
I've had it for about 5 years now, so it was probably about 95, 96, somewhere in there.
What all is involved with maintaining and keeping and driving an old fire engine?
Perpetual work.
What kinds of things have you had to do to it to keep it on the road?
This one, we found the flywheel and clutch assembly was ready to fall off when we had it in Downers Grove. So that was a wintertime project. Had to take the bottom half of the engine apart and the clutch and flywheel and all that out. It was a project.
I have to say, I don't know that much about fire engines. Let's start out with the name. Where does the name American LaFrance come from?
In the mid-1800s, there was a gentleman by the name of Truxton LaFrance that started a fire engine company, a machine manufacturing company, started manufacturing steam engines, and then went into motorized fire apparatus, merged with the American Fire Company, and that's where you get American LaFrance from.
Could you tell me something about the drivetrain on this machine? It has to be pretty reliable.
It's pretty reliable. We'll pop the hood and take a look at the engine. The engine is built with, it's a six-cylinder engine. It's about 760 cubic inches. It's got triple ignition. It fires on two coils and one magneto. It goes through the transmission, through a gearbox, through a jack shaft to chain drive.
Right. Now, how many people can this fire engine carry?
We've had 15 in a parade at one time.
Sounds like about the size of our audience. You want to go for a ride on an old fire engine? Can we take our audience for a ride?
Let's go for a ride.
Let's go for a ride in a 1931 LaFrance fire engine. Thanks. Thanks, Jim.
You bet, Chuck.
Let's go for a ride. How did you get involved in fire engines in the first place?
Well, I always wanted an old truck to restore, but couldn't afford the pickup truck types, and just kind of resigned myself to finding an old farm truck or dump truck or something along that line to restore, and went to a tractor show one time and the 46 Chevy was there. Price was right, so.
Oh, there's somebody out there right now. They're looking at this fire engine. They got kids. They want to give their kids memories. What advice do you have for anybody that's looking for an old fire engine to restore and use in parades, things like that?
Join your local fire apparatus group, Chicago Area's the Fire Buffs of Illinois. get to know the trucks, get to know the people, get to know the market, and then buy one. Have a lot of fun.
This is an open cockpit. This must have been hell in January.
Yeah, I can't imagine. I've driven it in rain. I've driven it in cool weather. I can't imagine driving this through a snowstorm or sub-zero. The guys 70 years ago must have been a lot bigger, a lot braver, a lot goofier. This one, as you see it, it's in what you might call original or working condition. What I'd like to do eventually, save enough pennies and have a real good paint job put on, gold leaf pinstriping, gold leaf lettering, as it would have looked in 1931 when it came from the factory.